Hello everyone, I'm Alisha and welcome to the Google Play Policy Bytes India video series. These videos are meant to simplify and help you navigate the Google Play policies so that you can continue building safer apps for billions of users around the world. In this video, we will walk you through the various policy guidelines on store listings and promotions. Before we begin, let's take a look at this example of Google Go app to better understand about the different store listing and promotion elements. To start with, an app's metadata consists of app's icon, title, developer name, description, screenshots, and promotional images. Think of this as an information that gives users first impression of your app, so it must be accurate and well-organized. Next, you will see the app's content rating, and this is also a very important element as users, especially the underaged ones, can find out suitable content using this information. And finally, you will see user ratings and reviews, and a lot of users refer to this information before downloading the app. To ensure a pleasant user experience, this section should never be manipulated. These elements give users more insights into the app and a better understanding of its current state, since app can change over time and often add and remove features. They're meant to be trustworthy and are a great way to share helpful information to assist users in finding great apps and games on the Google Play Store. Now let's go over some common violations of these store listing elements and how to avoid them. First, we will talk about our metadata policy. Your app title, icon, and developer name are essential to users making a decision on what to download. Kindly note that we do not allow misleading, improperly formatted, non-descriptive, irrelevant, excessive, or inappropriate app description, developer name, title, icon, screenshots, and promotional images. For example, new message dot indicator, when there are no actual new messages, and download or install symbol when the app is not related to downloading content. We also do not allow unattributed or anonymous user testimonials in the app's description, and emojis, emoticons, or repeated special characters in metadata elements. Please avoid all caps unless it is part of your brand name. And finally, your app title must be 30 characters or less. Here are some examples from app icon, title, and developer name section. This app has the word planner in all caps, even though it is not part of the brand name. Second, it includes special character sequences, for example, consecutive exclamation points that are irrelevant to the app. Third, it uses emojis, emoticons, including emojis, and special characters. Next, it also uses a misleading symbol, the new message dot indicator at the upper right section of the icon, when there are no new messages. Lastly, it includes a misleading text that says update now. Please do take a note that these are not allowed. Now, let's briefly discuss about the guidelines for user ratings, reviews, and installs. First, developers must not attempt to manipulate the placement of any app on Google Play. Also, inflating product ratings, reviews, or install count by illegitimate means, such as fraudulent or incentivized installs, reviews, and ratings is strictly prohibited, and this could lead to a direct removal of the app. Next, we will now take a look at a couple of common violations in ratings and reviews. The example on the screen will illustrate my point. This app is asking users to rate the app while offering an incentive. As you can see, the notification offers users a discount in exchange for a higher rating, and this is not allowed. However, do note that asking for user ratings and reviews without providing any sort of incentive is allowed, and ratings and reviews are really important in various ways, so keep encouraging the users to provide you the ratings and reviews. Another common violation is repeatedly submitting ratings to influence the app's placement on Google Play, and submitting or encouraging users to submit reviews containing inappropriate content, including affiliates, coupons, game codes, email addresses, or links to websites or other apps. This example shows a review that encourages users to promote the Rescue Robo app by making a coupon offer. Please note that this is not allowed on Google Play. Here are some more examples of common violations that we see where apps use prohibited images or text indicating store performance or ranking, such as App of the Year in the app icon and Best Slot Machine in the app title. First, number one in Magic Games and top three games in the app developer name. Best of Play in both icons and app title and award symbol in the app icon. Another type of common violation is usage of images or text indicating price and promotional information in the app icon, title, or developer name, such as 50% off or $50 cashback, sale or on sale for limited time, and 100 free spins or free 100. Lastly, apps must not have images or text that indicate Google programs in the app icon or title, such as editor's choice, new, etc. Kindly remember that these examples violate the store listing and promotion policy and non-compliant apps will be rejected. Here are some best practices when responding to user reviews. Keep your reply focused on the issues raised in the user's comments and do not ask for a higher rating. You can include references to helpful resources such as support address or FAQ page. Please note, ratings and reviews are benchmarks of app quality, and users expect them to be authentic and relevant. If this trust is broken, the user experience is significantly harmed, and we need to avoid that from happening. Let's now move on to app promotion. Do remember that we do not allow apps that directly or indirectly engage in or benefit from promotion practices that are deceptive or harmful to users or the developer ecosystem. This includes deceptive ads, including notifications that are similar to system alerts. Next is promotion or installation tactics that redirect users to download apps without informed user action. Another one is unsolicited promotion via SMS services and using sexually explicit ads to direct users to your app's Google Play Store listing for download. Next, I would like to share with you a couple of common violations of app promotion. The first example shows an ad that mimics system notification like your device has a virus and asking users to download another app, which is also an installation tactic. The second example mimics Android system notification and clicking it will lead to app download page. Please note, these are strictly prohibited and this will lead to direct removal of your app from the Play Store. Many developers appeal with an excuse saying it's an ad network's fault, but please note that the violation is found on your app and it is your responsibility to ensure that any ad network, affiliate, or ads associated with your app follows these policy. With this, we come to the end of the store listing policy guidelines. We hope you found this video useful. You can explore more policy-related videos mentioned in the description. Be sure to check out the free courses on Google Play Policy and remember to visit our Google Play Academy. Thank you for watching and until next time, stay safe and stay healthy.